In this video, we're going to show how to deploy ESXi and configure hardware in OpenManage Integration for VMware vCenter. Note, before you begin, ensure that the following are configured. A host credential profile, a bare metal server is discovered and compliant, a system profile, and ISO profile. OMIVV gives you an ability to baseline a cluster against a system profile, driver repository profile, and firmware repository profile. While doing an OS deployment, the baseline system profile is shown as a default option. However, you can override this. In this instance, we are proceeding with the baseline system profile. On the OMIVV homepage, click Compliance and Deployment, then Deployment, and then Deploy. Verify the deployment checklist and click Get Started. Select one or more bare metal servers and click Next. Select both the deployment options. You need to select System Profile or ISO Profile or both. In this video, we are selecting both System Profile and ISO Profile. Select an instance of vCenter which you want to add to the ESXi host after deployment. To select the vCenter destination container, click Browse. Select the desired data center or cluster where the host must be deployed and click OK. Optionally, you can select the host profile. The selected profile will be attached to the host. If the destination cluster is already baselined, the system profile associated with that cluster is selected by default. It is recommended to use this system profile to avoid a configuration compliance drift. You can override the default system profile selection by clicking Select Another. Select an appropriate ISO profile, then select the installation target for the OS deployment and click Next. Note: the option Deploy the hypervisor on the first boot disk for servers that do not have an internal dual SD module or BOS is applicable only if you are performing an OS deployment on multiple targets with varying internal storage configuration. The configuration preview job attempts to compare or verify the compatibility of the selected system profile against the selected host. To create a preview job on iDRAC, select an iDRAC IP and then click Preview. This step is optional. The operation may take a few minutes to complete, and you can view the status in the result column. If the preview job is not successfully run on the iDRAC, the status shows as not completed. Ensure that the iDRAC is accessible and perform iDRAC reset if required. To use the same host credential profile for all hosts, click Yes, and then select a host credential profile from the drop-down menu. To select the individual host credential profile for each server, click No, and then select the host credential profile from the drop-down menu. In the network settings, you can choose static or DHCP to get the IP address. In this video, we will use static network settings. Enter a fully qualified host name or FQDN for the server. A fully qualified domain name for the host server is mandatory. Make sure that the forward and reverse lookup entries are configured in the DNS, and the FQDN is resolvable prior to performing an OS deployment. Select the NIC which is used for the management network, and ensure that the NIC is in a connected state. Select the OMIVV network instance which has access to vCenter. Enter the preferred DNS server IP, alternate DNS server IP, IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway. According to your network configuration, you can choose to enable the Use VLAN checkbox and provide the appropriate VLAN ID for your management network. Note: when you are performing deployment on multiple servers, use the Apply Settings to All Servers to copy the common network settings. Then, enter the deployment job name and description. Finally, select the deployment schedule option and click Finish. You can track the status of the job in the Deployment Jobs page. Once the deployment job is successful, the host is added to host credential profile and inventory will be triggered. If any of the compliance criteria are not met, fix the compliance on the Management Compliance page. This completes the deployment. For more information about OpenManage integration for VMware vCenter, visit dell.com/support.